situation, condition. So let's entrust the Lord that in this kind of situation, we have the faith, we have the hope, and the love of God is always with us. So in a moment, I'll be sharing to you about the Word of God. In recent years, since 2004, according to my studies or what I studied about, looking for a message from the Word of God. So natural disasters have struck different regions of the world. So last January 2020, the Volcan Taal was erupted, and the nearby towns there was affected because of the ash fall, and some areas, and also in Mindanao last year and recent previous months was experiencing earthquake. So 2004, there is also a tsunami in Asia, Hurricane and Katrina, way back 2005, cyclone in Myanmar, way back 2008, earthquake in Haiti, way back 2010. So there's a lot of disaster was happening in our world since the time of Noah, the great flood was. So when disaster like this strike, people often raise questions. Yes, we often raise questions, mga tanong. Apay kastoy kasjay niya sa Ilocano. So the basic question or mga pangunahing tanong na tinatanong ng mga tao is, why did it happen? Did God cause it? If not, why did He allow it to happen? What can I do? What does it do any good? Does it do any good? So yan po yung mga tanong, no? In Tagalog, bakit nangyari yan? Anong dahilan? Bakit pinayagan na mangyari yan? Anong gagawin? Ano ba ang maidudulot na kabutihan sa bawat isa? So, way back 1985, since the Ethiopian famine, nagkaroon po ng tagutom famine. So may mga katanungan din doon, no? With the most recent disasters fresh on in our minds. So let's attempt to provide some answer. So ano bang mga sagot sa mga tanong? What is the answer to that basic questions? So I remember the song about science. So the song goes this way, in Tagalog, na bawat bata may tanong, bakit ganito ganoon. So the continuation of the song is, hayaang buksan ang isipan at para malaman yung mga kasagutan. So number one is, why did it happen? So, punta po tayo sa in our present situation. Why virus? Why incub? Why COVID-19 happen? So, did God cause it? Did God cause it? So it is common to call such natural disasters, viruses, pestilence, plagues, no? It's act of God. So perhaps because God has used natural disasters in the past, no? Like situation of Noah, the flood in Genesis chapter 6, destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah in Genesis chapter 18, famine, drought, pestilence, plague, war, earthquake against Israel. So according to Amos chapter 4, verse 6 to 12. So we can read it. So, but it would be a mistake to attribute all disaster to the hand of God or this COVID-19. So disaster are part of natural process in a planet evolution and ecology. So natural process. So sometimes God simply allows such events to run their course according to the time and chains. And so many experience tragedies due to no fault of their own. Some disasters are man-made. Yeah, man-made. Suffering often comes upon the innocent. Those we should not make the mistake of Job's friends presuming God on those who suffer tragedy. So in the life of Job, no, in Job chapter 42. So did God cause it? Without divine revelation, there is no way we can know if God caused it. So again, without divine revelation, there is no way we can know if God caused it. So, one of the answer, why did it happen? So, the revelation is in the word of the Lord, in His book, no? Make time to read His word, to understand His word, to pray what's happening. So we have different situation, especially I have read that in our status now financially we have different situation. It's okay for those who are on the top or rich or middle, or how about the poorest among the poor. So it's hard, no? Mahirap po na mawalan o wala tayong magagamit, no? So yeah, no? We have so many record, no? From the past and until now, we experience this kind of situation, no? So it's hard, no? The increase of the affected, no? In Asia, no? Philippines now is the number one in Asia. So what is the purpose of God, no? So that is the first question before, why did it happen? Why God allow it, or did God cause it? So we need to stick on the divine revelation. So the second question under why did it happen is, then why does God allow it? So the first one under the why did it happen, did God cause it? And under that is why does God allow it? Bakit hinayaan ng Diyos? Bakit hinayaan ng Diyos? Why God allow this previous disasters and this moment, the COVID-19, the hot issues all over the world. So if God didn't cause it, why does He allow it to happen? So kung hindi ang Diyos ang dahilan, bakit ito nangyayari? So, this relates to the overall problem of suffering, which God may allow for several reasons. So it keeps this world from becoming too attractive, encouraging us to seek something better. According to Matthew chapter 6, verse 19 to 21, Hebrews 13, verse 14. So, it can bring out the best in people. So, bring out the best in us. Like patience, generosity. So, we really observe, there are lots of trending situation right now about generosity. Our government needs to help the people of the Philippines to release a big budget to support, to help. So, also in the book of Romans chapter 5, verse 3 to 4, in James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4, it says, so it encouraged people to think of God. Yeah, amen. It encourages people to think of God, to draw near to Him in repentance, or asking the Lord for forgiveness, and people draw near to Him in repentance. So, whenever the innocent and righteous die, this situation of COVID-19, we have so many thousands of people died. Innocent or not, righteous or not, die. So, we should bear in mind to those innocent and righteous, the death of the righteous is precious in the sight of God. Amen. According to His word, the death of the righteous removes them from all suffering and evil, according to His word. Amen. The death of the righteous is truly a blessing, according to His word in Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. Even the innocent young are delivered from much heartache and sorrow. So they will be delivered. So whether caused by God or not, this pestilence, this virus, can result in much good. In much good. So the second question is, the first one a while ago is, why did it happen? Why did it happen? So the second one question is, why, what can I do? Ano ang gagawin natin? What can I do? So the first one here is, as we have opportunity. As we have opportunity, according to Galatians chapter 6, verse 10. As we have opportunity, we are to do good. Yes, we are to do good. No? What we can do depends on what we are able to do. So it's hard to do good or to share something na wala po tayo. But what we can do depends on what we are able to do. Our skills, our resources, whether we are nearby or far, if the need is nearby, we may be able to help directly. So, kapitbahay. So, we can help them directly. So, ano yung maitulong natin? Food, money, and etc. So, yeah. Mga previous disasters, mga weather skills, medical aid, no? Trash clean up with resources like medicine, food, clothing, shelter. If the need is far off, no? So we can help indirectly, no? Supporting those with skill who desire to go. No? So they can go like frontliners, no? They are the one. They are trained, no? To help, no? And supporting charitable organization, NGOs, no? So there's a lot of NGOs, no? Helping, no? So billions of dollars, thousands of pesos, no? Millions, billions to help, no? To help those in need. Yeah. So thoughts about charitable giving. So give to establish charities with experience in the affected areas, no? So in order to avoid corruption and etc. So and we can also send cash, no, to those who in need, no, to buy something, no, for their basic needs. So while donating tangible items, might be you feel better, giving cash is almost always a better option to understand, no? So we have a lot of like cash is best, no? So mga guides, no, how to share cash, no, to those who in need, no, in order for them, they have their own to buy their own needs, no? So that's it, no? As we have opportunity, so let's do. And the second one is do good to all. So do good to all, no? Gumawa po tayo sa ng kabutihan sa lahat, hindi lang sa kakilala lang or kadikit or lakas or relatives. So all as we have opportunity, we are to do good to all men, according to Galatians chapter 6 verse 10. So like the good Samaritan. So do good to all, no? Non-sectarians, no matter what their religion, no? Non-sectarians, charitable organization are especially good for this, no? For example, Doctors Without Borders, no? They can go to for especially good for immediate help, no? To rescue. Mercy Corps, especially good for long-term help. So long-term help po sila. So yes, we prefer non-sectarians instead of faith-based organization for general charity, because many of the latter teach false doctrines while they seek to help. So non-sectarians is who is one way, no, to help, to do good to all. Walang pinipili, all. So we should not hesitate to help those who may not be Christians. So kahit sino, pwede po nating tulungan. So especially the household of faith. As we have opportunity, we are to especially help our brethren, no? Our brethren. In Galatians chapter 6 verse 10, no? Yes, especially. That's why highlighted especially. So like Gentile Christians did for their Jewish brethren in Christ, no? According to his God's word, churches can certainly send aid directly to such Christians. So they can help. Individuals can sometimes use other channels, no? Open hearts, helping hands, no? They can share. And when we know of Christians in need, we should not hesitate to help. So either you are a pastor, because we are Christians, church leaders, or the members, yeah. So when we know, kung alam natin yung mga pananampalataya po natin ay nangangailangan, we should not hesitate No, don't be shy, no, to help. Huwag po tayong mahiya na tulungan po natin sila. So, if you ask me, I did it, no. It's hard to say na hindi ko po ginagawa. And when somebody is helping me, I also, they teach me to help others also. No. So, ganun po. Kung tayo ay natulungan, tinulungan ng ibang tao, they are teaching us to help others also. So, finally, we should pray. Finally, we should pray. So, we have the, some are doing fasting and prayer and fasting. yes, scheduled. No, we as Kamakop every Friday and Sunday, we're doing that. No, praise God to those who able to keep up to do it or to continue. And some are the prayer warriors, intercessors, doing prayer chain, no? 24/7. Now praying 1 hour, 2 hours, it depends on you. The more we pray, the more we see the needs. No? So finally, we should pray. It is our duty as Christians to pray for all men. First Timothy chapter 2:1-2. We should pray for those directly afflicted and their loved ones. Yes, let's continue to pray for them. We should pray for those providing relief, governments, NGOs, individuals, the frontliners. Let us continue to pray for them. Because the prayers of the righteous can accomplish much good, no? According to James chapter 5, verse 16. So, this virus, this COVID-19, disaster, past disasters are terrible. But they can be occasions for much good in this world. Again, this COVID-19, this virus, past disasters are terrible, but they can be occasions for much good in this world. No? So there's a lot what was happening right now because of home quarantine, enhanced community quarantine. No? So our Mother Earth, no? the pollution and etc. So though it costs, no, the lives of lots of people sacrifice, no, but for much good end this world. No? So the wicked can turn to God. No? The sinners, no? Those who are not yet come, return to God. No? They can turn to God. The righteous can draw closer to God. The righteous can draw closer to God. People can become more charitable. Amen? So, some individuals or there's a lot of challenge, no? So, the trending about challenge, no? So, people become more generous, charitable, helping. Fools can become friends, no? So, yeah, become friends. And that is good news. No? So, with faith in God and love for our fellow man, we can make the best of the situation. Again, with faith in God and love for our fellow man, we can make the best of the situation. Strengthening bonds between brethren, bringing communities together, appreciating what is really important in life. Amen? So, in times of this COVID-19, in times of moments like this, past calamity, past disasters, no? So let us trust in God and reach out to aid your fellow man. Let us continue to trust in our God and reach out to aid our fellow man. So this is the word of the Lord. When COVID-19, when the past disaster strike, we have lots of questions. Why did it happen? What can I do? And it is there in the word of the Lord. No? So let us keep on drawing near close to the Lord. And as what I said, no? And I believe the Lord will help us, no? To understand more and more. And thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. This timely message, no? From the word of God, as his or instrument, no? To the privilege, I grab the privilege, opportunity to share the word of God to each and everyone here in San Manuel Alliance Christian Alliance Church, my relatives and friends in Mindanao, Visayas, and here in Luzon and outside world. No? May the Lord continue to bless you. Please continue to pray to all pastors, messengers, workers, preachers, and to all and our frontliners, our men in uniform, our medical responders, our government, our family. Please continue to pray. If, as the word says, if by my people humble themselves and watching, let us pray. Lord, thank you for your words. Bless the hearers, bless the viewers. Meet all their needs, Lord. As we meet your needs, I release healing blessings of God in the name of Jesus. Help of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father in heaven. We ask all these things in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We ask all these things with faith. Everything, of purpose, which everyone wants. Again, Lord, thank you for everything. God bless Philippines. God bless the whole world. God bless you. God bless us. Thank you. In Jesus' name, we pray and I pray. So, again, thank you for your time. The Lord bless you. The Lord will keep take on you, take us, and the Lord will continue to make a way. God will make a way in every situation. God bless you.